Buchenwald translates into English as beech forest from German, but it is associated with much more. In this video, I tell the story of a gate at Buchenwald, the beech forest, perhaps the most distinct act of resistance against the Nazis, and their final solution. The story begins in Weimar in the early 18th century. Johann Sebastian Bach was the organist to the court there. Bach's time in Weimar was a period of composing keyboard and orchestral works. Bach transcribed a large number of works of Italian and Italianate composers. You can hear two different movements of two of his transcriptions in this video. The links to my recordings of them are in the description below. Later in that century, and at the beginning of the next, Weimar was home to Goethe, considered to be the greatest German literary figure of the modern era. This painting, entitled Goethe in the Roman Campagna, is quite possibly instantly recognisable to every German schoolchild. Goethe founded a literary and cultural movement, often called Weimar Classicism. This painting is classical, with a Roman aqueduct, a Greek frieze, and an Egyptian obelisk all present. Because Weimar was the cultural capital of Germany, after World War I it was chosen as the location to create the new constitution. The government made in 1919 would later be known as the Weimar Republic. Weimar was favoured over Berlin as the location for a conference to write the constitution because Berlin was seen as too imperialistic, and because there were riots in Berlin. Weimar, already filled with academics, with a theatre large enough to accommodate an assembly, was perfect for the task. Also in 1919, the Bauhaus School of Art and Design was founded in Weimar. Famous for its sleek, simple, modern design, the Bauhaus grew. Here is a crib, constructed from two rectangles, two triangles, and two circles, in the primary colours. It demonstrates typical Bauhaus design. The Bauhaus was also famous for its typography. The Nazis loathed the Bauhaus. They viewed it as a centre of communist intellectualism. Therefore, the school closed under pressure from the Nazi leadership in 1933. Now we move back to Buchenwald, the beech forest. It is located just outside Weimar. It was one of the first and largest Nazi concentration camps. Over 50,000 people died there, and 28,000 were imprisoned at one point or another. Most of the buildings have since been demolished, but the gatehouse remains. Here it is. The time on the clock is 3:15 p.m, the same time that American soldiers arrived to liberate the camp from the SS. You can see the gate to Buchenwald, open underneath the gatehouse. It is disconcerting being the size of a domestic door. The gate, which was seen by 280,000 inmates, looking back at the world they had left behind, was not meant to be read by the outside world. The side which the prisoners would read was repainted annually in bold red. The side facing the rest of the world was only painted once, when it was first installed. The gate, and specifically its typography, was designed by Franz Ehrlich, a communist prisoner pictured here. He had studied at the Bauhaus. Subsequently, he designed much more of the camp. This is the gate he designed. The text is Jedem das Seine, to each his own. Bach, who wrote so many pieces in Weimar, wrote the cantata Nur Jedem das Seine there, with its first performance in November 1715. Bach was not supporting a Nazi ideology by using this phrase. The Nazis flipped the meaning to suit their cause. They were uprooting German culture. Franz Ehrlich's typography is the most Bauhaus possible. The Nazis, who hated the Bauhaus as a school of communist ideologies, had Bauhaus typography on the entrance to one of their largest concentration camps, where it was seen by at least 280,000 captives. Only music can describe the horrors. Thank you for watching. If you enjoyed this video, then please like it, subscribe to my YouTube channel, and visit my website, godtress.wixsite.com/cornucopia, for more content like this.